All right, welcome back. This is going to be another episode of the M&M Show, coming to you live from Florida. I'm actually looking at all of the attractions, looking out my window, seeing the lights from Universal Studios and Islands of Adventure, and had a lot of fun. Felt like a kid. Okay. I asked Gamecock Nation, and y'all answered. Y'all gave a lot of good feedback, a lot of good close-knit memories that I read thoroughly through, and y'all put me back into 1984. Y'all really did. So that was pretty dope. I really appreciated it. It was really cool hearing y'all stories, and I may have, sure, y'all kept the thread going. The thread is probably still going, but it's pretty cool. But let me talk about my experience, because when I first got to USC, this was my second semester. I got an apartment at the Lofts. So this is 2010, sorry. So this is fall 2010, and I move in and I meet a guy, and his name is, I ain't gonna put his name out there, but I will say who his dad is, because he's related to the 84 team, and his dad was Kevin White. I'm pretty sure y'all remember that player. I think he was a four-year letterman. So it was pretty cool knowing that, that's how close it is. That's how very close it is, that my roommate's father was a member of the 1984 football team. So I'm going to take it back. Let's go back to 1984. I'm going to go back and read some of the responses that y'all put down. You know, what it was like, the feelings that y'all had, the experiences that y'all had. It was pretty cool. So let me go ahead and go through some of these. All right, so Gamecock Tuck gave his or her experience of 1984, and this is how it goes. Opening game, the Citadel was giving us fits. They led most of the game. Cock scored to take a lead on a halfback pass with about 3 minutes remaining. The Citadel returned the ensuing kickoff back around our 20. The Fire Ant defense stood up to preserve the win. The next week, we beat Duke, and then a big upset of UGA. Couple of wins against some poor competition. And then the 84 went on the road. 84 team went on the road at Notre Dame, and we're down big entering the fourth quarter. But Mike Holt led a huge comeback on the road at Notre Dame, 6-0. After a cakewalk against ECU, a thrilling victory at NC State kept the momentum rolling, 8-0. Top 10 ranked FSU rolled into Columbia. Raynard Brown took the second half kickoff to the house. Controversial if his knee touched, but it probably did, but no replay. He still took it 99 yards. Now I'm adding that, but let me get back to it. I attended most games that year, and in this game, I started a "We're number one" chant, which grew loud through the stadium. Nine and oh, baby. A buddy and I took a bus with other Gamecock fans up to Annapolis for game number 9 against Navy. Navy wasn't having a good year, and a running back stud, Napoleon McCollum, had been lost for the year. The weather was bad, misting, raining, and cold. The midshipmen ran to the end zone and did push-ups every time Navy scored. They scored often. It was miserable. Clemson was playing at Maryland that day, so we were seeing a lot of Clemson fans on the road, on the interstate. Luckily, Clemson had lost as well. We likely blew a shot at the Orange Bowl and a national championship. We were ranked number 2 going in, and number 1, Oklahoma, lost that Saturday as well. The team regrouped, though, with a thrilling victory next week at Clemson. We actually missed the extra point to take the lead, but offsides was called on Clemson, and the re-kick was good. A 22-21 victory in Death Valley. The final drive for the winning score led by Michael is still in my favorite. It's still in my mind. The best one drive in Gamecock history. Now, that's some detail. So, yeah, man, that would have been sick. And being in Maryland, literally not that far from the University of Maryland. Probably maybe an hour. Maybe, I don't even know. I'm not sure how far Annapolis is from College Park, Maryland. But it can't be that far. But, But you know what? You get back, you know, you go back to Cowtown and get that win. Hey, I bet it healed that loss real quick. All right. Let's check out Pablo SC. My wife and I were both students at USC that year. It was magical. We were at the Clemson game in Death Valley. It was the best time ever. I was walking through tailgate sites and just sitting down and eating their food and talking smack. They were in shock. It was funny. It wasn't like it is today, where people are violent. It was just fun. And they, Clemson fans, were just in shock, very quiet. Although to hear my wife talk about it today, and she thought I was going to get us killed. Simply the best game ever. You should have seen Mike Holt look at the fridge and hand him the ball or drop the ball at his feet when it was over. Dope. I like it. Kitchen Labs, he had a statement, or she. When the team came back from Notre Dame, everyone piled in their cars and headed to the airport. People were driving up and down Knox Abbott Drive, blaring their car horns. I will never forget. I bet so. NC Tag Man. I have a neat little story relating to the FSU game. About 17 or so years ago, I was driving on Harris Boulevard in Charlotte, sporting my new State of North Carolina Gamecock tag. I stopped at a traffic light, and another car pulled up beside me and hit the horn. The driver signaled to me to lower my window. He said, "Gamecock fan." I said, "You bet." Then he said, "I played there." I replied, "What's your name?" To which he replied, "Raynard Brown." I simply said, "Florida State, 1984, 99 yards. A big smile erupted on his face, and he seemed very excited that some stranger remembered that some 17 years ago. He was very happy, to say the least. We both saluted by sounding our horns as the lights changed, and I think it made his day, so to speak. I must admit, kind of made mine too. Go Cox. Hey, that's a dope experience. And I got to say, that would have made my day too. All right. So now we have Big Jer 54. And Big Jer shared his experience by saying this. Check it out. We were ranked 2 and Nebraska 1. If only we would have beat Navy at their place. If so, we would have played for the national championship. Obviously, we weren't ready to play. But I have to believe all the blame was not on the players and coaches, but Bob Macrum, the AD, and the year before he agreed to change the game from Cola to Navy just because Navy was crying about never having their seniors play more than 5 home games. That was the reason. Well, that bonehead agreed to us going to Annapolis if they would have made it up. Well, make a long story short, if he would have stood his ground, we would have never lost to them at home, in my own opinion. He was partly to blame. That was one of the reasons he was fired, because he didn't take care of business. It was bad business decision, period. I digress. Yeah, that's a bad decision. You already played tough enough games already. Why you make it tougher for yourself playing road games? It's like us picking to go to UCF on the road And we did that. And we almost lost, but we won. All right. So we're going to go to L Train for USC. And he or she wrote, I was in the fourth grade. The Navy game was the first and only time I cried over a game. The next time will be after a national championship. The next week we listened to the Clemson game on the radio. Then we went and bought a new TV to watch it at midnight because Clemson couldn't play their games live on TV as part of their probation punishment. And I still had that TV until 2001. Wow. Yeah. Crying over a game. Well, let me tell you something. Some of the worst losses I endured during my tenure as a Gamecock fan. I want to start with Florida, 2006. Oh my goodness, Jarvis Moss, the block field goal in the swamp. When we had Ryan Suckup, you know he was going to knock it down. Had a strong feeling he was going to knock it down. South Carolina outplayed Florida the whole game. The eventual national champion, Florida. Man, and they blocked the kick. Goodness gracious. And they went on to rip up Ohio State in that freaking national championship game. God. Tennessee, 2003, double overtime game. Man. Maybe it was a single overtime or overtime, but either way, we lost in OT. And that was hard. Man. Florida, 2002. We lost by two because of a failed two-point conversion. Georgia, 2002. I know y'all remember that. Fumble at the one-yard line. Clemson 2003 and Clemson 2002 had my head boiling, had my blood boiling. I think those are some of the worst losses that I had. And of course, you can talk about maybe the SEC championship, but we had no business. We weren't going to beat the Auburn Tigers that day. But yeah, those are some of the losses that I remember. I think Florida 2006 may be the worst loss I may endured. Because that would have been a big time win. That 2006 Gamecock team was a tough team. They were very close to being a 10-win football team. Couple of bounces here and there. They were a tough team. They were fun to watch. All right. But I just wanted to share some memories, man. Sitting here on vacation, man. I'm going to be back at work this week. But just want to go in and share these memories, man. Give y'all something to listen to while we in this period waiting for September 1st when they're taking those Chanticleers from Conway and there in Williams-Brice. And we're going to get that 2018 season kicked off. But this is the Eminem Show signing off. And hope to see y'all next time.